say he's a dead man.
That's what happens. Somebody turns tail on us.
We don't play with each other. Like to be sure.
Randall, I rode a long way to kill you.
I'm not a lawman anymore. I've given it up.
I got kinfolk in the grave because of you. Get us one coffin ready.
You raped and killed a 15-year-old girl. Being drunk is no excuse.
I don't remember a thing. I was drunk.
The fact is, Mr. Wilson, you did it. I sentenced you, Frank Wilson, to hang by the neck until death. May God have mercy on your soul. There's one spot left on the scalpel. The hanging will take place at 4 o'clock this evening. Court is adjourned. Mr. Randall, your only witness, the Undertaker, says that he can't recall who drew first. But then two other men said that they saw you shoot Joe Carson down in cold blood.
They were with him?
Mr. Randall, you put 6 shots in Joe Carson, and he never cleared his holster. How do you explain that?
I thought that the 3 were going to draw down on me. I knew that I didn't stand a chance. I just wanted to make sure that I took Joe Carson with me. Besides, I heard him tell the Undertaker to get one coffin ready, and I knew that it was meant for me.
Maybe there was a death in the family. Mr. Randall, from the information that I have gathered, you are guilty of murder. And under the law, I have no choice but to hang you.
Does it mean anything that I didn't resist arrest? I could have taken your death from you.
Yes, Mr. Randall, it does. But that doesn't change the fact that murder is a hanging offense.
Do you remember when we strung that man up down in Santa Cruz? How he got down on his hands and knees and begged for his life? I just don't think the history books have got it right.
What do you mean by that?
It says in the history books that Nathan Hale regretted that he had but one life to give to his country. Now, do you think he really said that?
Yes, I think he said it. He knew he was going to die, so he just held himself together and went out with respect.
But did he really mean it, or did he say it just to go out with respect?
I don't think that's important. He was a brave man, and he died like a brave man.
You hear that? You're going to have an audience waiting on you. All you'd have to do is say something patriotic. You might go down the history books.
Mr. Randall, you used to be a lawman, and a good one. You will work for me, or you'll hang. And that, Mr. Randall, is a promise. Marshal Clayton, Randall's escaped.
It's Randall. Tell the men to get mounted. Let's get after him.
Marshal Clayton is spotted. If they catch us, they'll hang me for sure and you have another owner.
Forrester beat us to the market by one day. It cost us $1 a head. I don't want it to happen again.
Miss McFay, we're not going to be able to meet our schedule and take it easy on these men both. And you cannot have it both ways. That's all there is to it.
You knocked Slim Foster's teeth out last week and kicked Joe Green's head in the week before. Now, we're not going to be able to make this schedule if these men aren't able to work.
Marshal, he's crossed the state line. What do we do now?
Drag him back across the line, we'll string him up.
Clayton, you don't have any jurisdiction here. You just crossed the state line.
Comstock, I'm after Randall. He killed a man in Hays City and sent us to hang, but he escaped. Now you send him out.
You're not coming through here.
Comstock, if I catch you cross the state line, I'll hang you myself. You hear me, Comstock? I'll hang you myself.
That's enough, Mr. Comstock. Enough.
These men are robbers and killers. All they've ever done is use a six gun. And I'm ready to show them who the boss is.
That's enough, Mr. Comstock. You're treating these men too brutal.
I don't trust this Randall. Things just don't add up.
I'll check out his story myself. But until then, don't beat him anymore, because I want him able to work. Mr. Randall, your story checks out, but I just don't buy it. I know that you killed a man and were sentenced to hang in Hays City. But no one escapes a hanging rope in Hays City. It's just too secure.
You know, you make a good cup of coffee.
Now, I've talked to Mr. Comstock, and I've decided to keep you on.
You know, in your eyes, Mr. Comstock is a saint. It don't change the fact that he killed three men in that last bank robbery, Red Rock. I realized that he had to shoot his way out of town. These were men with families.
If it weren't for Mr. Comstock, I would have lost my ranch. And until he steps out of line here, I'm going to keep him on as my foreman.
Well, Mr. Randall, it's like this. Right now, I need you to do a little fence mending, chopping a little wood, and just in general, getting around just doing the small jobs that we need around here right now, because I realize you're not feeling too good. But as soon as you get in better shape, I expect you to get back out there on the range with the rest of the men and do your full-time job. Hey, Randall. Take this hammer once you get started on the fence.
Randall's story checks out, but I just don't buy it.
I don't believe any man ought to have a chance to prove himself. But it's just like this, I'll have to keep a close watch on him.
Well, whatever you do, don't run him off, because we know we could use that extra good hand. Plus, what I'm trying to say is, stick to ranching and stop robbing banks. Because if he is a lawman, this way he won't have nothing on you.
Well, I'll just have to keep a close watch on him because, I don't know, I hope he gets along good with the rest of the hands. That's the only worry I have at the present time.
All right, Reb, drop that gun. Come on out. Yep, that's the Reb. Get me a rope around that tree.
Marshal, you're not going to hang this man. We represent the law. It's our place to take him in.
We're hot on Harper's trail. We can't take prisoners. This man killed a man in cold blood in Red Gap. We can't turn this man loose.
Marshal, I don't know part of this. You hang this man, and I will report it.
You got to give me a fair trial.
The storekeeper in Red Gap had a wife and three kids. You shot him down in cold blood.
We've been riding these horses hard. It would kill them to ride them all the way to Hayes City. What's it going to be, your horse or his life?
You seen what he did to that woman. She hadn't been the same since. Now, you're a man with a family. Do you want me to turn this man loose?
Well, I guess we don't have any choice.
Okay, Harper, get on your horse and get out of town.
I'm not leaving till the job's finished.
What job is that?
Sheriff, I rode a long way to kill you. See, you beat me here.
Yeah. I heard the fireworks in the street. You shouldn't have killed that Sheriff Harper.
I did that to put Clayton and his deputies on our trail.
Harper, you must be out of your mind.
We could set up an ambush, but that's not the way I want it. I want to meet Clayton face to face.
You put our lives on the line for your own personal gain.
Clayton stands in our way. We'll be a whole lot better off when he's out of the way.
Yeah, I guess you heard about him killing Rev.
He shouldn't have got caught.
A law man, always a law man. Too bad you have to die.
That was just a joke, wasn't it, friend?
Randall, I told you I don't line up gunplay around here, and that means you're going to have to leave. But before you do, step out back with me. I want to show you something. Randall, that little pea shooter of yours don't have a chance against this little jewel right here. And I'm going to tell you the truth. If you ever cross me, I'm going to let you know it.
dogs back there in yonder, and I'm going to tell you what, them old gals is in a bad state. All the hands will need to be fine with anybody. How about taking care of somebody? We need it. The horse rigged and ready to go. Make it South Fork in the morning. But we're going to play. We got to go. I mean, if there's a bunch of cattle out there and they're sick, we're going to have to get them.
All right.
And you tell them to come on and meet us up there.
All right.
It's South Fork.
I sure will. Take care.
Well, Marshal Clayton, are you expecting any trouble?
Not really. Most of these folks are drovers. Stop by town to get liquored up, kick their heels up a while. Some of them stop by the general store for supplies. I normally let them go on as long as possible without any real trouble. Besides, the town would be dead without their business.
Marshal, I come to kill you for what you did to Reb.
Boy, I ain't got nothing on you. You hadn't broke the law. Now you better walk while you can still walk straight.
Stopped up here to water my horse. Besides, I thought this was the bay property.
Next bay's property stops over there on the other side of the creek.
Well, it's the horse is thirsty, not me.
Okay, go ahead and water your horse. Take off that gun belt first.
Thank you, appreciate it. Your husband's clothes just fit. He must have been about my size.
Mr. Randall, I can use a good man to help with the work around here, but it could be dangerous living this close to the McFadden Ranch.
Well, I thought that Mr. Comstock was in full control of the land.
Mr. Comstock is in full control, and he will take action if things gets out of hand. But it can't be everywhere at one time.
I killed a man in self-defense, and I was taken to Hayes City to stand trial. Even though the evidence was against me, the judge knew that I was innocent. I was given two choices. Either work with Marshal Clayton and his deputies or hang. It wasn't a hard decision.
What was your assignment?
There's a feud between the two outlaw gangs, the Comstock men and the Will Harper gang. I was to work from the inside, find out when the next bank robbery was to be, and report it to Marshal Clayton. When he and his deputies chased me to the Fay Ranch, that was just a cover-up, just to get me in.
18. My husband got killed. I was on my own. And I took working up in a saloon until I was too old and men were younger and pretty women.
Was it all that bad? I mean, being young and all, we all had the urge when we were young.
Mr. Randall, that'll be just about enough. There's wood to be chopped before dinner.
Remember shooting that sheriff over in Holler Gap? He had a wife and three kids. And that doesn't bother you?
No, why should it? He should have known the consequences when he put on the badge. He could have been a farmer, a rancher, many things he could have done. But no, he wanted to take the easy way out. He couldn't stand the pressure, and when the time came, he bit the dust.
Mr. Randall? There's a lot of work to be done on the farm. Water the animals, collect the eggs, milk the cows, and plow the fields. I guess what I'm trying to say is I need a man that I can really count on.
Maybe I can outlast Mr. Combs.
That's what I got to do. I got to pick up the pace.
Does it bother you killing all those men?
When it hits my good side, it does. But that don't last. I like the danger, the challenge. I like being feared when I ride into town. Any gunfighter that says different is a liar.
Why do you say that?
Because we live in the sticks. Most people don't even have a telegraph. With a clean shave and a change of my name, I could be a farmer. But I don't want to be.
Well, you know, that Mr. Comstock, that's an animal for me. He beat me about half to death. I'm afraid that we're going to have trouble with this man in the future. I don't really want to shoot him. I'm going to have to deal with him on his own terms. I feel the only way to beat a man like that is to outlast him. I want to chop all the wood. Carry all the water, as much and as fast as I can.
You know, I used to walk 2 miles to school, there and back. Mom would fix me some good old pinto beans and hot biscuits to take with me. Where did the time go?
My father was a gunsmith. I worked with him in the shop, and I learned all about guns. How to break them down. How to put them back together. Even check my powder and my ammo. Just like a farmer, a man owns a farm. His son helps him in the fields. I made up my mind that if I was going to learn how to put a gun together, I was going to learn how to use one.
What do you have?
Myself a glass of spring water. Thank you.
Randall, I thought I'd find you here.
I just thought I'd come in and cool off. I'm homesteading now, and I came in to get supplies.
I just want you to know, Marshal Clayton, that I'm not going to work with you.
You've been assigned as deputy under me by the judge in Hayes City.
Well, that was to escape the hang rope. Well, I said, Marshal Clayton, I don't know you or the judge in Hayes City a thing, because both of you knew that I was innocent. The way I said, you're no more than a killer with a badge. You probably kill more men than Harper himself. Most of your prisoners, they don't even make it back to stand trial.
Well, Randall, I see you're not going to cooperate. I'm warning you, if I catch you across the state line, I'll hang you myself.
I really hate to disappoint you, Marshal. I really do, but I'm planning on homesteading myself. I might just marry this woman I've been helping. You're not going to catch me on the other side of the state line. I promise you that. Well, that really sounds great to me.
We're going to take the bank in Twin Peaks. They just have one sheriff and one deputy. The bank's not very well guarded. They've never had any trouble, and I don't really believe they expect any.
How are you going to go about that, Harper? No, I just don't think it'll work.
I'm going to create a disturbance. I'm going to kill the sheriff and deputy, and I need you for backup. I want Carson to lead the rest of the men into town. When we fire the shots, that's going to be all the attention on us. I want the men to hit the bank from the rear. We'll stay back for cover. Sheriff, I rode a long way to kill you.
You never killed me by yourself, Harper, because I'm faster than you.
I'll give you the first reach.
Lester, you drop that shotgun. Where are you standing?
How did they ever get a woman jailed?
It was some crazy senator's idea. He said that a woman couldn't do the job.
Well, it looks like she went out of her way to prove him wrong.
Marshal, it's just come over the wire. The Harper gang has just robbed a bank at Twin Peaks.
They'll be headed for the state line. We better stop them before they get there.
They must be riding them horses hard. They didn't even bother to pick up their hats.
Well, they're going to have to stop and rest them. When they do, we'll get them then.
Well, Harper wasn't with them. Well, just take the money off of them, and we'll return it to the bank.
There was no excuse for this ambush. No excuse whatsoever. Hey, you do get results, but your gun has chopped down more men than any outlaw wanted dead or alive.
That's where you're wrong, Your Honor. Will Harper has killed more men than I have.
I don't care. I want it stopped.
These are men with guns. I put my life on the line to do my job while you sat behind the confounds of this desk. Well, you've hung more men than me and Will Harper will ever kill. What I'm saying, Your Honor, don't tell me how to run my job.
Your job is the only thing standing between you and the hanging rope. And if I find out that any of these killings were unjustified, you're going to be relieved of it. Do I make myself clear?
You know, I talked with Reverend Blackwell last week. He's got a church about 20 miles down the road near Holly Creek. He invited us for Sunday morning services. I thought maybe we could leave one Saturday morning, camp out Saturday night, and we could be there in time for Sunday worship services.
I just can't leave them. Leave everything like it is, and I still stay in fellowship.
The Harper gang just took over the bank at Twin Peaks. And I really need some of the men so I can go ambush this Harper and take his money.
I don't hear nothing of the sort. That's blood money. I'm not going to have any part of it.
Well, Harper's been in my way for a long time. And I'm fixing to put a stop to him.
Well, I can't spare the men. There's cattle that have to be ranched up. There's fences that have to be mended. And there's stables that have to be cleaned out.
Well,
Marshal Clayton, I heard about you drawing down on the Harper gang.
Well, Harper wasn't there. He challenged me to a gunfight, and I agreed to meet him.
I didn't think you'd fall for anything like that. I mean, you got your deputies.
Well, I've been chasing this man for 2 years, and it made me look pretty bad not showing up with him. Besides, I wanted to get it all out in the open. Plus, I think I can take him down.
Well, I think you're making a big mistake. I think that, you ought to stick with your deputies. I mean, that's what they're for.
Ah.
Mr. Comstock, after this cattle drive's over, I was wondering, would you like to go on the hayride with me? Or, well, I guess your mind isn't really on the hayride.
Well, actually, it's not that I'm not interested. It just is that these men are kind of restless, and I don't know if I can keep these men straight or not. So I'm just having a hard time really knowing whether I'm going to be able to keep them straight or not.
Man, Randall got that woman all to himself, and ain't no need to let a good woman like that go to waste.
I agree with that. That's the truth, boss.
I think we'll just saddle up, get Pop Leather, and go get her.
Let's go do her.
Let's go get her.
That suits me.
Let's kill the fire. Put the car out and let's go.
All right, here we go get her.
You men are not going to leave this camp. Any man messing with that woman will answer to me.
It's gonna be a hot day. I think I'm gonna set this down and rest a while.
Randall, ain't you getting tired of sleeping on that couch?
Well, I'm not complaining.
I realize it's a man's place to ask the woman to marry him. But I'm asking you, and do you think we have a chance?
Well, yes, I think it's a chance.
Well, I'm thinking about in 2 months.
Well, that's just too short a notice. I mean, something that serious. Why not 2 years?
Life is short. And I don't want to keep on living like this.
I'm on my way to meet Harper. If I don't make it back, you're next in line for the job. The judge is well pleased with your job as lawman. What I'm trying to say is, if you don't like the way I'm running things, maybe you'll have a chance to change them.
Well, Marshal, I wish you good luck. I guess in your own sick mind, you feel you're doing the right thing.
Well, at least I'm doing something, Randall. You're sitting here doing nothing.
Every gunfighter's got to stop. I go with this natural to me. I believe in using two hands. And my life is on the line with this team. I go with the cross draw because that's what comes natural to me. People criticize it, but I just be untwisting the right foot. I can give myself all the leverage I need.
Marshal Clayton told me that you killed 3 men in a standoff. Ain't nobody that fast. Couldn't have been any good.
Well, they weren't all that slow. It happened in a bar. One of them tried to draw from a sitting position. The other's gun jammed off.
Maybe it just wasn't of his day. Joe Hill killed 3 men in a card game in Cheyenne, but he was gut shot. He died shortly after that.
Mr. Randall, you couldn't outshoot me.
Well, there's a whole lot more to it than how straight you can shoot. Or how fast you're on the draw. The main thing is you got to mean it. No hesitation. The instant that my gun clears the holster, my finger is on the trigger. Not bad.
Well, Harper, I've waited a long time for this. It'd be a shame to end it too fast. Here, let me pour you a drink. Well, Harper, tell me a sad story. Tell me why you become an outlaw. Did you have an unhappy childhood, or was your old man strung up by the law?
As a matter of fact, he was. I was a little young to really know what was happening, but I do know that everyone said they were going to town to watch a man hang. They enjoyed watching the life go out of that man, like it was a show. And ever since that day, I've been against the law. The law-abiding citizens and everything that they stand for.
Well, Harper, I'm just all broken up.
You've had your say. Let's get on with
woman, you know what we come after. Make it easy on yourself.
That's far enough. Take another step and I'll kill all 3 of you.
Woman, you know you ain't gonna use that gun.
gonna be a hot day. I think I'm gonna set this down and rest a while.
Randall, don't you get tired of sleeping on that couch?
Well, I'm not complaining.
I realize a man is supposed to ask a woman to marry him, but I'm going to ask you. Do you think there's a chance?
Well, yes, there's a chance.
Well, I want to know something in 2 weeks.
Well, that's awful short notice. I just feel that something that serious 2 years would be more like it.
I don't want to keep on living like this.
Well, I'm just going to have time to think.
Time is short.
Honor the memory of Flo Wilson, who died a tragic but yet unnecessary death. We're sorrowed that she is not here with us today, but let these words of Scripture soothe our troubled heart. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, you know, and the way you know.
Reverend, I appreciate you coming.
Is there anything else I can do?
Yes, I'd like to have her body transferred to a church cemetery. To be buried with church-going people. I feel that she deserved that.
I'll see that it is done.
Reverend Blackwell, I just want you to know that I've been sworn in as a deputy to Hayes City Lawman. I just want you to know that I'm not going in vengeance. It's just that, well, there's nothing else left for me.
Well, praise be, and may the Lord be with you in all that you do.
Marshal Clayton has been killed, and I've been appointed by a judge in Hayes City to take his place.
Well, I treated Logan for his wounds, but then I ran him off. Because if Mr. Comstock would have known this, he would have hung Logan himself.
The way I see it, the three of them rushed the cabin. Miss Wilson killed two of them in self-defense, and the other killed her, but I'll never know what really happened until I catch up with Logan.
Well, I believe that the only place that Logan's going to be safe is if he joins up with that Will Harper gang. Now, I know they're holding up in El Cater, because Mr. Comstock told me so.
Well, I'm going to have a talk with Mr. Comstock.
He works for me, and I'll take care of the situation.
Mr. Comstock, if you cross that state line, you'll hang for sure. You have a normal life as a rancher on this side, and that's why you're not going.
Who's stopping me?
I am.
Well, we'll have to see about that situation. I thought you'd learned your lesson before, Mr. Randall.
Is that all you got, Comstock? Just hit me again. Comstock, just hit me again. Again, Comstock.
You're riding with a punch, Randall. Get up and fight like a man. You didn't beat me, you just outlifed me.
You know, Comstock, I could put you out right now. If you don't follow me across the state line, there's no need to.
He won't be going with you, Mr. Randall.
I came after Logan. He worked for Comstock. He's the one man responsible for killing a woman I was planning on marrying. I want to take him with me to Hayes City to stand trial.
It's Bill Carson you're looking for, not Logan.
I thought Carson was dead. I thought that I'd kill Carson.
It was his kid brother that was trying to imitate him. The way I see it, Randall, he killed your woman, you killed his kid brother. That makes you evil. The good best thing you can do is get out while they're getting us good.
I can't do that. I'm alone.
Randall, you didn't come after Carson. You came to die. You don't stand a chance. My men have already taken over the town.
That's right, Harper. I came here to die. I know that I'm going to die. Before I go, I want to make sure you kill nobody else.
Prove it, Randall.
Well, it looks like I'm going to die. It's just too many of them out there for me. But I'm not going to make it easy on them. I stand a whole lot better chance in here than on the outside. They'll have to come here after me.
Sniper out here, boys, and we're gonna have to get him before he picks us all off. But first, we'll take care of Mr. Randall.
They're gonna have to come here and get me. Looks like I'm going to die. There's too many of them out there for me. But I'm not going to make it easy on them. They're going to have to come in here and get me.
Nah. I'm not dead. I'm going to burn you out. I'd rather burn you out and waste my bullet. Because I don't like a snake. And you're just like a slimy snake to me.
Thank you.
you to save one for me, Comstock, because I'm looking forward to killing you. But I don't believe I'm going to do that. I believe I'm going to hang you.
So you said it. You're faster than me, Carson. You think that you're faster. Well, I give you a chance to test your speed for his life. All you got to do is take that rope off his neck and I'll come riding in. But if you and your friends shoot me down before I get there, everybody will know that he was afraid to face me. Are you afraid to face me, Carson? Are you afraid?
Carson, you said that you was faster than him. Well, I give you a chance to test your speed for his life. A cross drop from the set. Every gunfighter's got to stop. I go what feels natural to me. I believe in using two hands. And my life is on the line with this hand. I go with the cross draw because that's what comes natural to me. People criticize it, but I just be untwisting the right foot. I can give myself all the leverage I need.
Marshal Clayton told me that you killed three men in the standoff. Anybody that fast couldn't
have
been any good.
Well, they weren't all that slow. It happened in a bar. One of them tried to draw from a sitting position. The other's gun jammed on. Maybe it just wasn't the other's day. Joe Hill killed three men in a card game in Cheyenne, but he was gut shot. He died shortly after that.
Mr. Randall, you couldn't outshoot me.
Well, there's a whole lot more to it than how straight you can shoot. Or how fast you're on the draw. The main thing is you got to mean it. No hesitation. The instant that my gun clears the holster, my finger is on the trigger. Bad.
shame to end it too fast. Here, let me pour you a drink. Well, Harper, tell me a sad story. Tell me why you become an outlaw. Did you have an unhappy childhood, or was your old man strung up by the law?
As a matter of fact, he was. I was a little young to really know what was happening, but I do know that everyone said they were going to town to watch a man hang. They enjoyed watching the life go out of that man, like it was a show. And ever since that day, I've been against the law and the law-abiding citizens and everything that they stand for.
Well, Harper, I'm just all broken up.
You've had your say. Let's get on with it.
Woman, you know what we come after. Make it easy on yourself.
That's far enough. Take another step and I'll kill all three of you.
Woman, you know you ain't gonna use that gun.
Said that they saw you shoot Joe Carson down in cold blood.
They were with him?
Mr. Randall, you put 6 shots in Joe Carson and he never cleared his holster. How do you explain that?
I thought that the 3 were going to draw down on me. I knew that I didn't stand a chance. I just wanted to make sure that I took Joe Carson with me. Besides, I heard him tell the undertaker to get one coffin ready, and I knew that it was meant for me.
Maybe there was a death in the family. Mr. Randall, from the information that I have gathered, you are guilty of murder. And under the law, I have no choice but to hang you.
Doesn't mean anything that I didn't resist arrest. I could have taken your death from you.
Yes, Mr. Randall, it does. But that doesn't change the fact that murder is a hanging offense.
Do you remember when we strung that man up down in Santa Cruz? How he got down on his hands and knees and begged for his life? I just don't think the history books have got it right.
What do you mean by that?
It says in the history books that Nathan Hale regretted that he had but one life to give to his country. Now, do you think he really said that?
Yes, I think he said it. He knew he was going to die, so he just held himself together and went out with respect.
But did he really mean it, or did he say it just to go out with respect?
I don't think that's important. He was a brave man, and he died like a brave man.
You hear that? You're going to have an audience waiting on you. All you'd have to do is say something patriotic. You might go down to history books.
Mr. Randall, you used to be a lawman and a good one. You will work for me, or you'll hang. And that, Mr. Randall, is a promise.
She deserved that.
I'll see that it is done.
Reverend Blackwell, I just want you to know that I've been sworn in as a deputy to Hay City Lawman. I just want you to know that I'm not going in vengeance. It's just that, there's nothing else left.
Well, praise be, and may the Lord be with you in all that you do.
Marshal Clayton has been killed, and I've been appointed by a judge in Hay City to take his place.
Well, I treated Logan for his wounds, but then I ran him off, because if Mr. Comstock would have known this, he would have hung Logan himself.
The way I see it, the three of them rushed the cabin. Miss Wilson killed two of them in self-defense, and the other killed her, but I'll never know what really happened until I catch up with Logan.
Well, I believe that the only place that Logan's going to be safe is if he joins up with that Will Harper gang. Now, I know they're holding up in El Cater, because Mr. Comstock told me so.
Well, I'm going to have a talk with Mr. Comstock.
He works for me, and I'll take care of the situation.
Mr. Comstock, if you cross that state line, you'll hang for sure. You live a normal life as a rancher on this side, and that's why you're not going.
Who's stopping me?
I am.
Well, we'll have to see about that situation. I thought you'd learned your lesson before, Mr. Randall.
Thank you.
Randall, I thought I'd find you here.
I just thought I'd come in and cool off. I'm homestead now, and I came in to get supplies. I just want you to know, Marshall Clayton, that I'm not going to work with you.
You've been assigned as deputy under me by the judge in Hayes City.
Well, that was to escape the hang rope. Well, I said, Marshal Clayton, I don't know you or the judge in Hayes City a thing, because both of you knew that I was innocent. Well, I said, you're no more than a killer with a badge. You probably kill more men than Harper himself. Most of your prisoners, they don't even make it back to stand trial.
Well, Randall, I see you're not going to cooperate. I'm warning you, if I catch you across the state line, I'll hang you myself.
I really hate to disappoint you, Marshal. I really do, but I'm planning on homesteading myself. I might just marry this woman I've been helping. You're not going to catch me on the other side of the state line. I promise you that. Well, that really sounds great to me.
We're going to take the bank in Twin Peaks. He just held me.
Thank you.
My life is on the line in this team. I go with the cross raw because that's what comes natural to me. People criticize it, but I just be able to twist in the right foot. I can give myself all the leverage I need.
Marshal Clayton told me that you killed three men in the standoff. Anybody that fast couldn't have been any good.
Well, they weren't all that slow. It happened in a bar. One of them tried to draw from a sitting position. The other's gun jammed on. Maybe it just wasn't the other's day. Joe Hill killed three men in a card game in Cheyenne, but he was gut shot. He died shortly after that.
Mr. Randall, you couldn't outshoot me.
Well, there's a whole lot more to it than how straight you can shoot. Or how fast you're on the draw. The main thing is you got to mean it. No hesitation. The instant that my gun clears the holster, my finger is on the trigger. Bad.
Well, Harper, I've waited a long time for this. It'd be a shame to end it too fast. Here, let
That's what they're for.
Mr. Comstock, after this cattle drive's over, I was wondering, would you like to go on the hayride with me? Or, well, I guess your mind isn't really on the hayride.
Well, actually, it's not that I'm not interested. It just is that these men are kind of restless, and I don't know if I can keep these men straight or not. So I'm just having a hard time really knowing whether I'm going to be able to keep them straight or not.
Man, Randall got that woman all to himself, and ain't no need to let a good woman like that go to waste.
I agree with that. That's the truth, boss.
I think we'll just stab up, get Pop Leather, and go get her.
Let's go do her.
Let's go get her.
That suits me.
Let's kill the fire. Put the fire out and let's go.
All right, we'll go get her.
Thank you.
You men are not going to leave this camp. Any man messing with that woman will answer to me.
It's gonna be a hot day. I think I'm gonna set this down and rest a while.
Randall, ain't you getting tired of sleeping on that couch?
Well, I'm not complaining.
I realize.
Well, Marshal Clayton, I heard about you drawing down on the Harper gang.
Well, Harper wasn't there. He challenged me to a gunfight, and I agreed to meet him.
I didn't think you'd fall for anything like that. I mean, you got your deputies.
Well, I've been chasing this man for 2 years, and it made me look pretty bad not showing up with him. Besides, I wanted to get it all out in the open. Plus, I think I can take him down.
Well, I think you're making a big mistake. I think that you ought to stick with your deputies. I mean, that's what they're for.
Mr. Comstock, after this cattle drive's over, I was wondering, would you like to go on the hayride with me? Or, well, I guess your mind isn't really on the hayride.
Well, actually, it's not that I'm not interested. It just is that these men are kind of restless, and I don't know if I can keep these men straight or not. So I'm just having a hard time really knowing whether I'm going to be able to keep them straight or not.
Man, Randall got that woman all to himself, and ain't no need to let a good woman like that go to waste.
I agree with that. That's the truth, boy.
I think we'll just bad luck get Pop Leather and go get her.
Let's go do her.
Let's go get her.
That suits me.
Let's kill the fire. Put the car out and let's go.
All right, we'll go get her.
You men are not going to leave this camp. Any man.
We got most of the chores done today. I don't really know what we did yesterday. It's just good to have a little time off.
Well, we could go fishing.
Well, that really sounds great to me.
We're going to take the bank in Twin Peaks. They just have one sheriff and one deputy. Bank's not very well guarded. They've never had any trouble, and I don't really believe they expect any.
How are you going to go about that, Harper? No, I just don't think it'll work.
I'm going to create a disturbance. I'm going to kill the sheriff and deputy, and I need you for backup. I want Carson to lead the rest of the men into town. When we fire the shots, that's going to be all the attention on us. I want the men to hit the bank from the rear. We'll stay back for cover.
Well, Marshal Clayton, are you expecting any trouble?
Not really. Most of these folks are drovers. Stop by town to get liquored up, kick their heels up a while. Some of them stop by the general store for supplies. I normally let them go on as long as possible without any real trouble. Besides, the town would be dead without their business.
Marshal, I come to kill you for what you did to Reb.
Boy, I ain't got nothing on you. You hadn't broke the law. Now you better walk while you can still walk straight.
Stopped up here to water my horse. Besides, I thought this was McFay property.
McFay's property stops over there on the other side of the creek.
Well, it's the horse is thirsty, not me.
Okay, go ahead and water your horse. Take off that gun belt first.
Thank you, appreciate it. Your husband's clothes just fit. He must have been about my size.
Mr. Randall, I can use a good man to help with the work around here, but it could be dangerous living this close to the McFadden Ranch.
Well, I thought that Mr. Comstock was in full control.
Is if he joins up with that Will Harper gang. Now, I know they're holding up in El Cater. Because Mr. Comstock told me so.
Well, I'm going to have a talk with Mr. Comstock.
He works for me, and I'll take care of the situation.
Mr. Comstock, if you cross that state line, you'll hang for sure. You live a normal life as a rancher on this side, and that's why you're not going.
Who's stopping me?
I am.
Well, we'll have to see about that situation. I thought you'd learned your lesson before, Mr. Randall.
Is that all you got, Comstock? Just hit me again. Comstock, just hit me again. Again, Comstock.
You're riding with a punch, Randall. Get up and fight like a man. You didn't beat me, you just outlifed me.
You know, Comstock, I could put you out right now. If you don't follow me across the state line, there's no need to.
Mr. Comstock, after this cattle drive's over, I was wondering, would you like to go on the hayride with me? Or, well, I guess your mind isn't really on the hayride.
Well, actually, it's not that I'm not interested. It just is that these men are kind of restless, and I don't know if I can keep these men straight or not. So I'm just having a hard time really knowing whether I'm going to be able to keep them straight or not.
Man, Randall got that woman all to himself, and ain't no need to let a good woman like that go to waste.
I agree with that. That's the truth, boy.
I think we'll just bad luck get Pop Leather and go get her.
Let's go do her.
Let's go get her.
That suits me.
Let's kill the fire. Put the fire out and let's go.
All right, we'll go get her.
You men are not going to leave this camp. Any man messing with that woman will answer to me.
It's gonna be a hot day. I think I'm gonna set this down and rest a while.
Randall, ain't you getting tired of sleeping on that couch?
Well, I'm not complaining.
I realize it's a man's place to ask the woman to marry him. But I'm asking you, and do you think we have a chance?
Well, yes, I think it's a chance.
Well, I'm thinking about in 2 months.
Well, that's just too short a notice. I mean, something that serious. Why not 2 years?
Life is short. And I don't want to keep on living like this.
Marshal Clayton has been killed, and I've been appointed by a judge in Hays City to take his place.
Well, I treated Logan for his wounds, but then I ran him off, because if Mr. Comstock would have known this, he would have hung Logan himself.
The way I see it, the three of them rushed the cab. Miss Wilson killed two of them in self-defense, and the other killed her, but I'll never know what really happened until I catch up with Logan.
Well, I believe that the only place that Logan's going to be safe is if he joins up with that Will Harper gang. Now, I know they're holding up in El Cater, because Mr. Comstock told me so.
Well, I'm going to have a talk with Mr. Comstock.
He works for me. And I'll take care of the situation.
Mr. Comstock, if you cross that state line, you'll hang for sure. You live a normal life as a rancher on this side, and that's why you're not going.
Who's stopping me?
I am.
Well, we'll have to see about that situation. I thought you'd learned your lesson before, Mr. Randall.
Is that all you got, Comstock? Just hit me again. Comstock, just hit me again. Again, Comstock.
You're riding with a punch, Randall. Get up and fight like a man. Randall, he killed a man in Hayes City and sent us to hang, but he escaped. Now you send him out.
You're not coming through here.
Comstock, if I catch you cross the state line, I'll hang you myself. You hear me, Comstock? I'll hang you myself.
That's enough, Mr. Comstock. Enough.
These men are robbers and killers. All they've ever done is use a six gun. And I'm ready to show them who the boss is.
That's enough, Mr. Comstock. You're treating these men too brutal.
I don't trust this, Randall. Things just don't add up.
I'll check out his story myself. But until then, don't beat him anymore, because I want him able to work. Mr. Randall, your story checks out, but I just don't buy it. I know that you killed a man and were sentenced to hang in Hayes City. But no one escapes a hanging rope in Hayes City. It's just too secure.
You know, you make a good cup of coffee.
Now, I've talked to Mr. Comstock, and I've decided to keep you on.
You know, in your eyes, Mr. Comstock is a saint. It don't change the fact that he killed three men in that last bank robbery, Red Rock. I realized that he had to shoot his way out of town.
say he's a dead man.
That's what happens when somebody turns tail on us.
We don't play with each other. Like to be sure. I'm dead, but he's a horse. You still have to be there. You have to drink him on that wild wind.
He had a wife and three kids. That doesn't bother you?
No, why should it? He should have known the consequences when he put on the badge. He could have been a farmer, a rancher, many things he could have done. But no, he wanted to take the easy way out. He couldn't stand the pressure, and when the time came, he bit the dust.
Mr. Randall, there's a lot of work to be done on the farm. Water the animals, collect the eggs, milk the cows, and plow the fields. I guess what I'm trying to say is I need a man that I can really count on.
Maybe I can outlast Mr. Combs.
That's what I got to do. I got to pick up the pace.
How did they ever get a woman judge?
It was some crazy senator's idea. He said that a woman couldn't do the job.
Well, it looks like she went out of her way to prove him wrong.
Marshal, it's just come over the wire. The Harper gang has just robbed a bank at Twin Peaks.
They'll be headed for the state line. We better stop them before they get there.
Well, Harper wasn't with them. Well, just take the money off of them, and we'll return it to the bank.
There's no excuse for this ambush. No excuse whatsoever. Hey, you do get results, but your gun has chopped down more men than any outlaw wanted dead or alive.
That's where you're wrong, Your Honor. Will Harper has killed more men than I have.
I don't care. I want it stopped.
These are men with guns. I put my life on the line to do my job while you sat behind the confounds of this desk. Well, you've hung more men than me and Will Harper will ever kill. What I'm saying, Your Honor, don't tell me how to run my job.
Your job is the only thing standing between you and the hanging rope. And if I find out that any of these killings were unjustified, you're going to be relieved of it. Do I make myself clear?
You know, I talked with Reverend Blackwell last week. He's got a church. Thank you.
Sheriff, I rode a long way to kill you.
You never killed me by yourself, Harper, because I'm faster than you.
I'll give you the first reach.
Lester, you drop that shotgun. Where are you standing?
What you did to Rail.
Boy, I ain't got nothing on you. You hadn't broke the law. Now you better walk while you can still walk straight.
I just stopped up here to water my horse. Besides, I thought this was Fay property.
Makes Fay's property stops over there on the other side of the creek.
Well, it's the horse is thirsty, not me.
Okay, go ahead and water your horse. Take off that gun belt first.
Thank you, appreciate it. Your husband's clothes just fit. He must have been about my size.
Mr. Randall, I can use a good man to help with the work around here, but it could be dangerous living this close to the McFadden Ranch.
Well, I thought that Mr. Comstock was in full control of the land.
Mr. Comstock is in full control, and he will take action if things gets out of hand, but it can't be everywhere at one time.
I killed a man in self-defense, and I was taken to Hayes City to stand trial.